actor and comedian Nick Offerman wears many hats. Best known for his portrayal of Ron Swanson on the long-running TV sitcom Parks and Recreation, Offerman started his career as a theater set builder, and he continues to run a wood shop in Los Angeles. A new Netflix miniseries released last week has Offerman co-starring as Colin Kaepernick's adopted father in Colin in Black and White. It's directed by Ava DuVernay, and it's about the former NFL quarterback. Offerman is also an author. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker caught up with him in a patch of woods in upstate New York to hear about his latest book.
As was the case for many of us, life slowed down for Nick Offerman when the pandemic arrived.
When it went down, I never got too freaked out because my life always shifts. I keep shifting hats.
An actor, a comedian, a carpenter, a furniture maker, a competition reality show host, Offerman's version of shape-shifting is an overlapping affair. One day may be spent in his wood shop, and the next playing the ornery Ron Swanson on the TV show Parks and Recreation.
I like saying no. It lowers their enthusiasm.
But Offerman has also written 5 books. His latest, Where the Deer and Antelope Play, was written during the slow days of the pandemic. Part travelogue, but more meditation on our relationship to the natural world. The book reflects on Offerman's time spent outdoors. It opens with his pre-pandemic trip to Glacier National Park with Jeff Tweedy, the frontman of the band Wilco, and acclaimed author George Saunders. Continues with a trip to the UK to visit author and farmer James Rebanks. And ends with him and his wife, actress Megan Mullally, on a road trip across a shutdown America, hauling a 30-foot Airstream trailer.
Our lives underwent a profound change where we were able to say, let's take 2 months on the road, and a lot of it will involve some state parks, some national parks, some more on-purpose hiking, which I was like, it's my new thing.
On-purpose hiking, yeah.
I've bought a couple specialized garments. I guess I'm a hiker.
Do you have the sticks yet?
No. Yeah. In part 3 of the book, a surprise character talks me into the sticks. So as soon as my knees start complaining enough, I'll come around.
Stick time.
Yeah.
It's a pretty little spot.
Offerman and I did some on-purpose hiking near the set of an Amazon miniseries he was filming.
So when you're out production, are you seeking out, like, oh, I need to go and spend an hour or two outside?
Well, you know, one of the great things about modern technology, no matter where I am, in a city or the country, if I have time off, whether it's a weekend or a week or an afternoon, I can pull out my smartphone and look at the map, and it shows me green places. When I was younger, I would Google the phrase, best cheeseburger in Pittsburgh, or best barbecue in any given place, and then I would hike to that place and eat a lot of meat.
On the surface, there is some overlap between Offerman's love of meat, whiskey, and woodworking, and the fictitious Ron Swanson, the character he played for 7 seasons on NBC's Parks and Recreation.
You've accidentally given me the food that my food eats.
Salad is traditionally the first course at a wedding.
Is a gerbil marrying a rabbit?
Swanson was the uber-manly, libertarian boss of Pawnee, Indiana's Parks and Recreation Department, distrustful of government while being fiercely protective of his loyal staff.
I do consider myself a bit of a Trojan horse. Inexplicably, there's a portion of the Parks and Recreation audience that didn't quite comprehend the sense of humor around Ron, and instead they were like, finally, we're represented.
This is the trick that is Nick Offerman. In the American consciousness, he is both the artist and the everyman. A beloved character, but also an author wrestling with our strained relationship with the environment.
I don't know how we are taking care of or how we are getting along with Mother Nature. And we need to pay attention to that, which has become strikingly clear in the time of climate change. And I'm not a scientist or a scholar. I'm a dancing jackass, you know, that makes canoes, who has a book deal. And so I was like, well, I'm going to do my best to sort of, you know, use whatever charisma I can find in my life to try and communicate this to my readership.
And this is how we can reconnect our lives to the world we live in, a theme pulled from his friend, novelist, poet, and farmer, Wendell Berry. For decades, Barry has written about the decline of rural communities and how large agribusiness has separated us from where our food comes from and the land that must be cultivated and cared for.
I told Wendell Berry many years ago if I could just get a job communicating his writing to people, I'd be happy with that career. And it's working out because here comes some more. But he writes really wonderfully about, you know, something from his purview on his Kentucky farm, seeing society go faster and faster. And he says, so what are you, you know, what did that buy you? It's so true what he says, that there's more, there's actually more in an acre of land to fill your lifetime if you just stop and actually look at it.
As he writes, these were the ideas running through his mind as he hiked in the mountains of Montana just before the pandemic with Jeff Tweedy and George Saunders, a trio Offerman describes as a, quote, bromance with a shared artistic vision.
We're all three on this lifelong project of how can we help? How can we use our art, our gifts, whatever they may be, to get more people to care about other people?
Offerman says for his part, that means embracing his many shapes and doing it with as even a keel as possible.
I don't mean this in a false way. I'm grateful that I'm simple. I have a steady demeanor that comes, I think, from my farming family, that I'm able to not get it, I'm able to avoid panic and say, okay, the house is on fire. There's three exits. Everybody, do you get the, you know, grab the scotch, you grab the jar of change, and make sure we have a deck of cards, and we'll be all set. And that's my saving grace, is I can say, okay, I can't remotely begin to fix any of this stuff. I can do my part, which is like write this book or take part in a TV show that has a good-hearted message of love or empathy or whatever. And that, I can do that.